Two-spirit peoples embody the strengths of both male and female energy and are valued as sacred gifts for traditional Indigenous peoples. Historically, Indigenous peoples who were gender variant, or what we call two-spirit today, were held with esteem for the vital contributions they had to their communities. For Indigenous people today, life continues to be a journey of respect, inclusion, and stewardship. Each person is essential, offering purpose, value, and a responsibility to their community. Social roles within Indigenous societies cannot be compared to Western gender norms, as social positioning develops out of the individual's skill, spirit, ability, and age, as gifted to them by the Creator. Before Europeans colonized North America and settled on Turtle Island, Indigenous peoples lived a life of diversity with distinct cultures, worldviews, and languages. First Nations, Inuit, and Métis still do today. As customary Indigenous knowledge and culture has survived, there exists common values that echo from time immemorial, including the strong, committed relationships to the land and the community. Settler culture has unfortunately disrupted Indigenous paradigms by enforcing limiting gender binaries and heteronormativity. Colonization has used violent ideals to impose the unnatural dissection of gender variance into only female and male roles on Indigenous people, asserting inflexible idealism and ultimately causing cultural rupture within Indigenous traditional ways of being. Upon contact, Europeans imposed dominant notions of patriarchy and heteronormativity by forcing unrealistic psychological and sexual expectations on Indigenous peoples and the social roles of the male and female. Destructive modes of assimilation intended to destroy cultural identities and to reprogram Indigenous peoples to the norms aligned with Western ways of being included mechanisms such as the residential school system and policies like the Indian Act. Heteropatriarchy aims to disempower and devalue two-spirit people who once held high honor in their community, thereby dangerously pushing them further into the margins. The impacts of colonization continue as settler agendas challenge notions of the civil, sexual, and political sovereignty of First Nations, Inuit, and Métis people. The violence against Indigenous people is unfortunately demonstrated through multiple tiers of continued genocide over the last 500 years. There is so much to be collectively gained by Indigenous people's knowledge, language, and paradigms in relationships to the land, oneself, others, the environment, and how we function as diverse people with complex identities. As an identity that meets many intersections, two-spirit peoples unfortunately face a unique and particularly violent discrimination. There's a lot of work that has to be done. Higher rates of homelessness, poverty, and a lack of access to culturally appropriate healthcare services are only some of the barriers faced by two-spirit people. Through reconciliation and reclamation, two-spirit people are using their voice to live authentically in Canada by confronting the impacts of colonization. It is time, as settlers, to change behaviors, challenge discrimination, and become allies who are welcome to the diverse perspectives and insights of First Nations, Inuit, Métis people, including Two-Spirit people.